Alright, here is the mold wizard assignment. So you're going to start off, you're going to have a model very similar to this one, and you're going to go into the mold wizard, and somewhere, okay, so if the mold wizard is not, if you don't see it on there, then just touch that, go to applications and click on the mold to enable the mold wizard, and you're going to start by initializing the project. Put this, make sure before you even do any of this, start with the part file in a directory that you have write access to and one that you don't mind filling up with dozens and dozens of files. Go ahead and keep the defaults for all of this except for the material. We'll go ahead and ask for ABS. You see that it applies the shrinkage value for ABS. That comes out of this, but we're not going to get into any of that. But we're just going to take it take the defaults otherwise. We'll say OK. And we will also take the defaults for the part name management. All right, and you'll see that it has created some files in an assembly. Most importantly, probably, is this top file. This is the file, the sort of main project file that you're going to be working in the whole time. Alright, now what we're going to do is go ahead and tell NX how this part's going to be positioned in the mold. Basically what the draw direction is going to be, how it's oriented in the mold. With this part and the part that you're going to get, it's basically already done for you. We do want to make sure this says product body center. We want to lock the Z position and say apply. And we just want to make sure that it's down here in the center, and that the z-axis is pointing into the cup shape there. All right, now we're going to define the cavity and core inserts, basically the workpiece. So come up here to workpiece, and yet again we're just going to take the defaults because this comes in looking pretty good. Whoops, went a little fast there. I mashed the mouse wheel and accepted that, but you'll just take the defaults on that and pull it up again so you can see. Should be something like this. Your values will probably be a little bit different because your workpiece may be a little different than this one, but they should be within this range. I'll just say OK. Now we'll do the check regions and let NX see what's cavity, what's core, as best it can tell. When you come in here and you click set the color of faces, if they are already defined, you'll be able to see them. So we'll come in here and we'll calculate reset all. Apply that, come to the face, and click face, and then set color of faces, and you'll see that it's should be set. Then we'll go to define regions, and this is how you'll know whether you did that step properly or not. You should have no undefined regions when you're done with that step. And with this model, he sees three different regions that form the cavity side and four that form the core side. Alright, so what we, if we don't have zero undefined regions, then this is not going to work. Alright, I missed a step there. If you see, we turn on parting lines, there's nothing to see. It hasn't actually created the parting lines. This was the step where we should have done that. So we'll say create regions and parting lines. We'll say apply, and now you can see, if we turn off the workpiece, you can see that is the actual edge where the parting line is. All right, now we'll turn that that parting line into the divider between the two parts of the mold. Come here to design parting surface, and what we want is this bounded plane. Keep in mind, these are your clipping planes turning, cutting off because we've gone beyond what we're used to seeing here. What NX is trying to display. We'll do fit, bring that back in, and all we want to do is bring this in a little bit closer. Let's look at it head on. We just want to make sure that we're slicing all the way through that that body there. So we'll say OK. All right, now we'll define the cavity and core. That sheet is what we want. That should already be selected. and we'll say apply. All right, and what he's doing, he's showing us the core side, and we'll say okay, that is what we want. And so he's defined the core side, that's the cavity side. And then again, apply. Cavity side. Oh, and then advance to the core side. Apply that. There's our core side. And we'll say okay. All right, we'll move back to our top part in the model. And we can see our cavity and core sides there. We can come here to this little view manager tab, and we can look at this, and we can turn on and off the different sides just by selecting over here. If we want everything, we just click top. All right, now we're going to do our cavity layout. Select cavity layout. He already sees the body that we want to use. We're going to use linear. And we want a 2x2. We want 2 in the X, 2 in the Y. All right, we'll say start layout. And we get our multi-cavity layout. And then we want to do an auto center. So you see the coordinate system is centered on one of the cavities. We want it centered on the all of the cavities. So we'll auto center, and that will shift everything onto the center point there. All right, now we're ready to put in the mold base. So we'll come here to the mold base library. And let's see, the one we're after is under DME. And we'll come here to a style 2A. And the index that we want, we'll pull this down. We want a 30-30. And we want APH to be 56. And BPH also be 56. So you can see on here that's defining the A plate and the B plate on the mold. All right, I think that's everything. We'll say OK. And all of the mold components should be brought in from the library. All right, should have something about like this. Okay, now we're going to put the locating ring in here. So we'll come to our standard parts library, and the one that we're after, let's see, is under this strack mm locating ring. We see a Z12 90 mm, and I think the defaults are good for the rest of that. We'll say okay. All right, so there's our locating ring in place. All right, now we need to put in the sprue bushing. So we'll come back to our standard part library. Now, this one is a Hasco. I think this is the right one, Hasco MM. We're going to look under injection. I think this is the right one. We'll take that and use a 66 mm. long catalog length, and let me just check the rest of those numbers. This O here, that's, we're going to bump that up, go to the 4 mm. I think that's it. We'll say okay. All right, so there's our sprue bushing in place. All right, now for something even more exciting, we're going to put in the ejection pins. All right, so let's see, are these the ones? No, we're going to use Futaba ejector pin straight, EJ. Let's bump up to a 4-5 mm. Catalog length 150. Let me see, I think those are all the default. All right, we'll move this out of the way and we'll say OK. He's going to select a point. What we want is that point right there. Careful not to select another one. He's defaulting back to that point there. That is what we want. So we'll go ahead and say OK. And then we'll say cancel. All right, you'll notice that there's four of them in there because when we actually put that in, I didn't point it out, but it defaults back in to the part group. That's the individual mold, individual cavity, I mean. And so he multiplies that around to all the different cavities. All right, now we need to trim off those ejector pins. So I'm going to take and first suppress out of here hide the fixed half of the mold, hide the A half. And I'm also going to hide that little product right there. So what we're seeing here is the inside is the core and the ejector pin, which what we want is that to be trimmed off flush. Alright, so we'll come up here to ejector pin post-processing and we'll select, where is he? Well, that's, I hit the wrong one, so let me just cancel out of that for a second. Hide that. Alright, now try that again. Grab that pin and what we want to do is trim it to a selected face. We'll select that face and say OK. And now our pin is trimmed off flush with the inside of the core. All right, so now what I want to do is I want to isolate this core cavity region here so that that's all that we're looking at. And what I want to do is merge those cavities. All right, so our merge cavities command is here. All right, so for the cavity side, these are the cavities. And then on the core side, those. And you can see we've got cavity and core all together combined. All right, now we're going to put our cooling passages in here. Start with pattern channel and we want to put this on a sketch and we want this sketch to be offset from the edge or from the face of the part there. That should be about fine there. We'll need to lay out the X direction and let's see, he wants his start point. I'm gonna grab that one just at the origin. We'll be fine. Alright, so that will put us on a plane. Tip up and make sure that you're in a plane that's above the surface. It's above those cavities and it's not, it's in the plane where you would want cooling channels to be. And we're just going to make these real simple. I'm not going to put a lot of effort into these. There we go. Of course you would want to take and you want to do a little bit better job with those, but for demo that's what we're going to do. Alright, so our patterns are created and what we want to do is edit this a little bit. I'm going to flip up like this and what do we need to do? We need to extend some of these channels and extend and trim would be the same command. So let's start by extending this cross drilled channel in here out a little bit like this. And where it's going to end is where the base of that arrowhead is. So we'll say apply there. The other end of this, we'll want it to be flat. And we'll extend it to the edge like that. And these others need to be trimmed. And it's still the same command. Grab that little arrowhead and place him on the surface. Same with you. Like that. Alright, and then we want to define the actual circuits inside here. There's only going to be one, but we're going to start with the inlet. So this circuit begins here, and you see how he follows the path, and he says, you know, I've got really only one way he can go there, and then there are two ways he can go here. We want to select this one, and we want to come out at that point. We'll say okay. He did automatically come in here and put some pieces in there. We can come in there and let's go into circuit one, and we'll see what he put on the end here. He put this kind of connector, and actually what we want to do is change that. Since this is an insert inside our mold, we want to put an extension on that. So we'll put an extension plug on there, and the pipe plug is okay at this point here, and then at the inlet or the outlet, we also want an extension plug. All right. So I grabbed the wrong extension plug there. I think that's the one that I want, is the part family. All right, now what we should be able to do is turn those concepts into actual parts. You can come up here to this concept design, and we want to take, first we'll do that plug. So we'll say apply, and you can see he actually puts in the model of a pipe plug there, and we'll do the extensions as well. All right, so that's what we want. All right, I'm going to turn the A side back on, the fixed half back on here. And let's see, I want to hide. That little bit of core there. All right, what I want to do now is put in my runner system. So there is actually this command for runner. We're going to use this design fill command. And we're going to start by doing a four cavity runner like this. All right, we'll make a 5.5 mm big D, or D1, and the little d, yeah, 5 mm is okay for that. And let's go up to 6.5 for the big D. Specify the point. That is where we want it to go in. All right, and now what we can do is scale that to fit properly. I'm going to tip everything up like this so I can see what's going on. All right, so I messed around with a little bit, and I dropped down to a 4.5 for D1, 76 for my L1, and 40 for my L. And that seems to be what I want, so I'll say OK. And now what I want to do is put in my gates. All right, so back again to fill. And what we want to do is pull out this submarine gate. All right, and we'll come to the placement. If you do this right, it'll put it at all four terminations of that runner system. Okay, so if you don't get all four, you may have clicked just a single point in space and not actually selected that runner system. So be careful and watch out for that. All right, I'm going to come and lay it down like this. And let's see, I need to adjust my view a little bit here. All right, so I've got static wireframe. I turn my background black so you can see a little bit better. And what I want it to do is first flip these gates around. Get where I can see that. Go 180 degrees out with that. And then look at it from this orientation here and adjust this angle here. Where is it? A1. I can tip those up until I get into the cavity nicely with the whole tip. There, something like that. Apply those and OK. All right, and being submarine gates, we might not see them. There they are, deep in there. Okay, there are a couple of other steps that we would do if we were making an actual mold. We're not going to do them for the lab, but we would need to pocket out all of these pieces and parts because right now these plates are still full and solid and pocketing using the pocketing command inside. Where is that? Oh, I'm wrong thing. There we go. There it is, the pocket. I'm not going to have you do that for this assignment, though. But you can come in here and do the pre-process motion. And what you want to do, first of all, is add this kinematic model. And you're setting the machine stroke and ejection distance inside there. And then mount components. There should be a bunch of these already in place. We'll say apply. Okay. And then we can come to the, where is that thing? Run simulation. And simulate the part. He doesn't see the, there's the ejector pins. Oh, let's see, maybe he did see it. All right, so the part is not defined in here, so I need to make sure that that gets defined. All right, so to define that, all right, so we'll come out here, pre-processed motion, mount component, product, and we'll select the actual solid body for that product. Where is that? Oops. There it is. And this one. There he is. We'll just take those two. All right, and then now we can see the parts come out. There we go. So that's your assignment. Be sure to see the website for what to turn in.